Good morning. Welcome to Youth Sunday. This is a very special day for us. We will be sharing with you different things that we have learned and done during our vacation Bible school, as well as those of us who went to camp in June. And then we have other kids as well participating with us today. I do call your attention to the bulletin. Can someone give me a bulletin? I do call your attention to the bulletin. Please be sure that your school supplies are here by August 19th. We are having our Five Below weekend this coming weekend, this Friday, Saturday, and Saturday. And it's also tax-free weekend, and they're going to have a lot of buy one, get one free, buy two, get one free type stuff. So go and check out their deals, and then some of the money that you spend will come back to us. Be sure to look at all the different announcements that are in the bulletin concerning events that are coming up. Summer Adventures, if you have not already let me know that you're planning to come and you haven't been coming, there's no more room. I've actually had to recruit someone to drive a personal vehicle for this week and probably the extra weeks to come. But parents, remember, the only way to guarantee that your child has a spot on the trip is to pay in advance. And be sure, just look at all the different announcements that are in there. Yes.
Trustees asked me to make an announcement for them. And that is, things are a lot safer now, construction-wise, and they want to invite any of our church family who wishes to do so, to please go check out Heritage Hall while they're not working, like today, you know, or after their work hours. They want you to see it before they get the finishing done on the interior of the building. You'll be surprised at where the stage that they reached already. So they ask you to please go take a look at it. Thank you.
Okay, at this time we will be distributing our Sunday School awards for the last quarter. We did have three students who had perfect attendance for the last quarter, and they were Mackenzie Sasser, or Cece as we call her, Jacob Sasser, and Austin Hogan. And I'm going to have to wait to give you your certificates because I forgot to get the superintendent to sign them, but y'all can come on up and get your award. And then starting in our nursery, those who had high attendance, which means that they did not miss any more than three Sundays out of 13 Sundays. Starting with the nursery was Riley Balance and Micah Ash. So if someone can come forward and get theirs. Big sister's coming to get them. And And then in the preschool and kindergarten class, Logan Balance, and y'all just come on forward, Kathleen Flannery, Katie Ash, and Elijah Batts. And then in the next class, Savannah Etheridge and Gabriel Batts. And in our tween Sunday school class, Sarah Staten and James Staten. And in our high school class, Naomi Jenkins, Joseph Barnes, and Paul Link. Let's give all of them and their families who helped get them here a hand. All right, at this time, all of our kids who were here for VBS or who have been practicing the VBS songs, come and find your spots on the stage, and we will begin our worship service.
What you think?
Please stand and join us in the responsive call to worship.
Faith is the reality of what we hope for and the proof of what we don't see.
Lord, show us the way that we may follow you every day and live by faith. Please turn into your hymnals to hymn number 349. Join us in singing Trust and Obey. Stephanie, come forward and give us our invocation.
Lord, come and meet us here in this place. Let us learn from your word and apply it to our lives in order that we may become more like you. May you be praised in all that we do today. Amen.
Amen. Greet each other in peace. Matthew.
Gabriel.
Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. Proverbs 3:5.
Help us, Lord, to depend on you.
You must love your neighbor as you love yourself.
Help us, O God, to dare to care for others the way we do you.
For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, so that everyone that believes in him won't perish but will have eternal life.
We commit to claiming the name of Jesus and telling everyone we meet about his love for us. Jesus said in John 13:34, a new commandment I give to you, that you love one another as I have loved you. You also are to love one another. It has been said that you can give without loving, but you cannot love without giving. Give to the Lord and the work of his church out of your heart of love. Our ushers, please come forward to receive our tithes and offering. Is searching for all of his children, me and you. If our ushers will please come forward at this time. Jarrett, please lead us in our offertory prayer.
O Lord, take these tithes and offerings and use them to the building up of your kingdom, that you will be glorified throughout the whole earth. In Christ we pray. Amen.
Amen. You may be seated. I need Tyler and Savannah.
Choose today whom you will serve. As for me and my family, we will serve the Lord. Joshua 20:15.
We choose to follow the Lord forevermore.
Go into the whole world and proclaim the good news to every creature. Mark 16:15.
We will go into all the world and spread the truth of God's word until we have heard. We commit to changing the world by the words that we say and the things that we do. The next song will be by some of our older youth who went to Cragmont, and we have joining us today some of our friends from Daniel's Chapel as well as Free Union. So if y'all will please come forward at this time to sing Hold Me.
I know I should be working, but I'm thinking of you. And just when I feel this crazy world is gonna bring me down, that's when your smile comes around. Oh, I love the way you hold me by my side. You'll always be. You take each and every day, make it special in some way. I love the way you hold me in your arms. I'll always be. You take each and every day, make it special in some way. I love you more than the words in my brain can express. I can't imagine even loving you less. Lord, I love the way you hold me. Oh, 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 I love the way you hold me. Oh, 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 oh. Well, you took my day and you flipped it around. Calmed the tidal wave and put my feet on the ground. Forever in my heart, always on my mind. It's crazy how I think about you all of the time. And just when I think I'm about to figure you out, you make me wanna sing and shout. Oh, I love the way you hold me by my side. You'll always be. You take each and every day, make it special and some. I love the way you hold me in your arms. I'll always be. You take each and every day, make it special in some way. I love you more than the words in my brain can express. I can't imagine even loving you less. Lord, I love the way you hold me. Whoa, oh, 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 I love the way you hold me. Whoa, oh, 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 oh,
oh, oh, I'm so grateful and thankful for all you've done. Wish I could tell you in a short story or poem, but all I have is my voice and this guitar. And you have my heart.
Oh, I love the way you hold me by my side. You'll always be. You take each and every day, make it special in some way. I love the way you hold me in your arms. I'll always be. You take each and every day, make it special in some way. I love you more than the words in my brain can express. I can't imagine even loving you less. Lord, I love the way you hold me. Oh, 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 oh. Oh, 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 oh. love, I love, I love, I love the way you hold me. I love, I love, I love, I love the way you hold me. I love, I love, I love, I love the way you hold me.
Mm-hmm, I believe you can. Thank you. We take these moments to remember those on our prayer list. Please consult the one that's in your bulletin, and I have some other names, a good number of names, and some updates. Some praise items first. That's always a good place to start. I've already mentioned about the progress on Heritage Hall. Please take notice of that. Praise items for the miraculous progress of Dolan Atkinson at Vidant Medical Care in Greenville. Just amazing the progress that's been made. And a week yesterday is when he had his cardiac event, and it's amazing how much progress he's made. Also, Peggy Pope is making tremendous progress now, and that's great to see. So please continue to remember them. Mr. Charles Eatman came home yesterday from UNC Hospital. I talked with Ann this morning. He's doing great, so please praise God for that as well. Mr. Ray Benton, who was in the hospital, went home. Sandra says he's doing very well. Please add these names to our prayer list. Janice Barnes, Mr. Albert Turner, Mitch Howard. Patty's husband had back surgery at Wake. He's still at Wake, hoping to get home very soon. He's very anxious to get home, but please continue to remember Mitch. Barbara Mayo, Sam Mayo's mom, please remember her. She's just been diagnosed with cancer for, did you say the fourth time in her life? Fifth time, Suzanne says, in her life. Donnie Phillips, his wife asked us to remember Mr. Donnie Phillips, a local man here in town, in our prayers. Betty Britt, who is Joyce Tant's sister out in Virginia, please remember her. And Peggy Barnes, NH's sister, whose husband Ray died and was buried this past week. So please remember all of these in prayer. Are there any further spoken requests to be shared? How about by uplifted hands? Let us pray. Our gracious Father, Christ, who is the light of this world, in the dark times of our lives and the experiences of our world, you shine forth, lighting our way. We continue to praise you and pray for that light. On the footpaths of the wilderness moments of our lives, we seek refuge and strength in you. So, Lord, bring your care to all those who live in spiritual darkness, or those who struggle, or who mourn, those who suffer, those who live with great fear. Light of the world, as you walked toward your death, you had the confidence of victory. You had the assurance and the hope of eternal life within you. Grant us this confidence as well when we face troubles and temptations and trials and uncertainties in our lives. Light of the world, hear our prayers. Hear our petitions on behalf of those spoken, written, silent requests for which we pray. Holy light of God, grant us and all those whom we love, and even those whom we do not love, your peace. In the name of Jesus the Christ, we pray and believe. Amen.
Up to this point in today's service, you've heard bits and pieces of mainly what we've learned and experienced at Bible school. At Operation Overboard, as our shirts say, we learned to depend on God, dare to care, claim the name, choose to follow, and change the world. Now we will close the service with the focus of the camp week, which 19 of our children and youth attended in June. Our theme for the week was beautiful exchange, and we talked about surrendering our stuff, our status, our sin, and ourselves over to God in exchange for the rich blessings that we will receive. When we talk about surrendering our sin over to God in exchange for God's forgiveness, grace, and mercy, we must acknowledge that we are unworthy of this exchange. I think all too often this exchange is taken for granted. While we acknowledge that we are sinners, we don't really take the responsibility of our wrongdoings. We put the fault back in God's court. Well, I'm only human. God made me that way. I'm not perfect. Or we try to rationalize why we've done what we've done. Or we try to lessen the severity of our sins by comparing them to someone else's sins. Well, at least I've never committed murder. All too often, we unintentionally diminish the greatness of what God has done for us through the sacrifice of Jesus, his only son, on the cross. We have told ourselves that God should forgive us, that we somehow deserve a second chance. We fail to really understand how unworthy we are of God's forgiveness, grace, and mercy. In the past week, news stations have been constantly covering the tragedy of the mass shooting at the movie theater in Aurora, Colorado. We are devastated to hear of yet another mass shooting taking the lives of innocent people, and for no apparent reason. Our natural gut reaction is to want justice, or might I dare to say, revenge, for the one who is responsible for the bloodshed. This eye for an eye and tooth for a tooth mentality is only what seems fair in our human minds. Any discussion of forgiveness for James Holmes is met with the response of, but he doesn't deserve to be forgiven. He needs to be punished for what he has done. My friends, none of us deserve God's forgiveness. We are all unworthy of God's forgiveness. Yet when we ask God to forgive us, God has mercy and forgives us. But this is only possible because of grace. Let me explain these in terms a little more. Forgiveness is often done for selfish reasons. We sometimes decide to forgive another person because we harbor anger or hatred in our own hearts towards another individual. And we know that if we continue to do that, that it just ends up destroying us. In that sense, the forgiveness is not done for the good of the other person, but for us. This type of forgiveness is often the kind of forgiveness extended to individuals even when they do not ask for forgiveness. But we do it because of what that bitterness inside of us will do to ourselves, to us. Mercy, on the other hand, is what we have on people when they have wronged us for coming to us asking for our forgiveness. It's a type of compassion. We extend mercy to someone because we love them. We don't want the wrong that has been done to completely destroy our relationship with each other. So since they have acknowledged that they have done wrong and have asked for our forgiveness, we extend mercy to them. But grace is an entirely different level of forgiveness than what most of us are really able to wrap our minds around. Grace is when we forgive another person, even though they are unworthy of our forgiveness, and perhaps have not even asked for our forgiveness. Grace is what God offered to all of humanity in the form of his Son on the cross. We are unworthy of God's grace. There is nothing we can say or do to truly justify our sins and restore our broken relationship with God that has been created by the sins in our lives. So yes, James Holmes does deserve to be punished for the crimes he has committed, just like we deserve to to be punished for the sins we have committed. And perhaps James Holmes has not asked for forgiveness for the crime and the sin he has committed, but to say that we are only willing to forgive him of the mass murders for the good of our own selves, so that our bitterness and anger towards him will not destroy us from the inside out, is forgiveness for selfish reasons and not the type of forgiveness that God has offered to us. It's only when we are saying, when we are able to say, I forgive him for his sake and not my own, and not because he is worthy. I forgive him no matter how unworthy he is of that forgiveness. I forgive him for his sake and not my own sake, that we have come to understand the kind of forgiveness that God has called us to have. Romans 3:23, for all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. We are all sinners and unworthy of God's grace, mercy, and love. Luke 6:36 tells us to have mercy because we have received mercy. Ephesians 4:32 calls on us to forgive others as we have been forgiven, not because they deserve forgiveness, because none of us deserve forgiveness. Not for our own selfish reasons, because God didn't forgive us for our own good, but God offered us grace, forgiveness that is not deserved. Just as James Holmes is unworthy of our unselfish forgiveness, forgiveness filled with mercy and grace, we are all unworthy of the forgiveness, mercy, and grace that God offers to us.
Take this love away. Thank you. in a beautiful exchange. Oh, holy are you, God. Holy is your name. With everything I've got, my heart will sing how I love you. Holy are you, God. Holy is your name. With everything I've got, my heart will sing how I love you. Holy are you, God.
Holy is your name.
With everything I've got, my heart will sing how I love you. Holy are you, God. Holy is your name.
Everything
I've got, my heart will sing how I love you. Holy are you, God. Holy is your name. Everything I've got, my heart will sing how I love you. Holy are you, God. Holy is your name. Everything I've got, my heart will sing how I love you. Holy are you, God. Holy is your name. With everything I've got, my heart will sing.
We call on you at this time to come forward, to surrender whatever your sin is on the cross, acknowledging that all of us are unworthy of the forgiveness that God has extended to us through his grace and mercy, and most of all, his love for us. So also, we should surrender our sins and extend that love to others and go out and change the world through doing that kind of love and forgiveness. Please take your hymn and turn your hymn book and turn to hymn number 366. Join us in singing, "I Surrender All." I ask the youth if they will go to the back, gather in the back, so that you can tell them what a blessing you received from their leadership in the service today. Don't forget to get your Five Below brochure to be used for this Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, August 2nd, 3rd, 5th, 4th, I'm not sure. And at this time, Gayla will lead us in our invocation.
Let us pray. As you go forth into the world, may you depend on God to give you all you need. May you dare to care for others. May you claim Jesus as your Savior and friend. May you choose to follow the one true God whom you claim. And may your faith spread to others in a way that changes the world. May you dare to go deep with God in all you do. In Jesus' name, amen.